Hi everyone, welcome to something I've somewhat creatively titled In the Director's Chair. While my flair for naming sub-series of my videos is open to debate, the name is aimed at reinforcing a point. In this video, and others to come, I'm going to talk about director systems and their impact upon video games. Unlike our traditional perceptions of AI involvement in games, directors are different in that they oversee, or perhaps more appropriately, direct, the experience that the player has while playing a given game. For this inaugural video, we focus on arguably the most famous of director systems, which is found in Valve's Left 4 Dead. We'll start by talking about what directors are and how they impact the world, followed by discussing Left 4 Dead itself, before breaking down how the AI director guides gameplay. In case you've never played the game, Left 4 Dead is a four-player online cooperative shooter that's set during a zombie apocalypse. The goal is to reach the end of a series of maps that define a given episode of play. Players are able to wield a variety of firearms and explosives in their arsenal, with melee weapons introduced in Left 4 Dead 2. The crux of the gameplay is reliant upon players within a given team to work together to survive against a large number of zombie threats. This can mean providing cover fire, saving them when under heavy attack, and sharing medical supplies such as pain pills and med kits. While this is the core tenet of play, it's reinforced courtesy of the game's dynamic and often unpredictable behaviour. Surprise attacks by zombies are frequent and often very hard to predict. This often results in circumstances that only occur in that particular run of gameplay. I'd argue that, from a gameplay standpoint, this is the game's biggest strength, in that players have unique stories of events that took place within that particular episode. No two gameplay sessions are the same, and that helps bring players back again and again. Much like in film or theatre, a director system is tasked with ensuring actors know their roles and play the appropriate part when creating a particular scene. However, unlike most directors, director AI does not have full control of all the actors in the scene, since human players have a habit of doing whatever they want. In addition, the audience for their show are actually the active participants of the experience. As a result, directors are focused on modifying the world around the player to continue to make it interesting. And this is sort of at odds with a lot of the AI we've seen in this series thus far, given that it's often manifested physically in the world as a non-player character. Instead, the director oversees what is happening in the game and makes changes to the state that satisfy some base requirement. Often, a director is interested in managing what we will refer to as the flow of gameplay. We want to manage the intensity of play such that it peaks and troughs, creating periods of gameplay which has a very high intensity. This is when a director will typically make gradual changes that start to make the gameplay more dramatic, during which things will just go to and you'll need to bring your A game. Of course, we can't have the game run at high intensity at all times. It becomes a lot more stressful, and players ultimately need a respite, otherwise they'll simply burn out and may in fact turn the game off. As such, the director will recognise that after a certain period of time, the intensity should start to reduce and make changes to the game, or could actually be doing nothing, to allow the player to start to catch their breath. Of course, once the player has had a long enough respite, these peaks of intensity should return. It's important that these peaks and troughs are not always the same strength, meaning that the intensity of gameplay will continue to fluctuate and reach maximum peaks perhaps on more than one occasion as we proceed through a given level. The exciting and often hard to predict gameplay is driven by Left 4 Dead's director, an AI agent who directly manipulates the current state of the game world in an effort to keep players under duress. This is a crucial component of the game, given that it helps maintain a sense of urgency in players. It reinforces that you can't stay in the same place for too long. There's a need to keep moving and pay attention to what's happening around you. So how does the director achieve that? What's important to appreciate is that the AI behind the director isn't interested necessarily in killing players or winning the game. It doesn't treat the game in such an adversarial fashion. Rather, its focus is to maintain pace. Now, at first this might seem a bit odd, but this is the principle behind which all of Left 4 Dead is built. The game is built around a repeated sequence of events that have an impact upon the game's intensity, and it's broken up as follows. Part 1. The build-up. The director realises that players aren't really under any sort of duress. As such, the game increases the intensity level and focuses this on particular players. Part 2. The Peak. Director recognises that the intensity level has exceeded a particular threshold. As such, it makes one last play to keep those players under pressure. Part 3. The Relax Phase. Knowing that it needs to ease up, the director ramps down. What is exciting about this phase is it is now waiting to repeat the cycle. When it decides to do so can be dependent on a number of factors. Personally, I love the fact that it's watching you play and waiting for the right moment to start attacking once more. These three activities comprise one epoch of play, and the game will continue these peaks and troughs of intensity with varying strength and frequency. The interesting part is that this intensity is measured by assessing the stress level, or the perceived stress level, of the player. And that's largely focused on the number of zombies attacking players and the proximity with which they reach them. The more zombies at close range, the more their stress levels are perceived to increase. Furthermore, if a special infected is able to attack a player, and in doing so pin them down, their stress level will reach maximum. These are measured on a per player basis, meaning that the director will focus on players if their stress levels are lower than others. So how does the director change the game world to accommodate? In short, it adds zombies to the map as you move through it. In actual fact, when you start the game, the map's empty. The director then decides to start adding zombies into the map in order to provide a challenge. This starts with the wanderers, individual zombies that are simply roaming around on their own. These are placed largely on the main path of the map and will attack you if you get too close. Meanwhile, mobs, larger groups of zombies, are added in groups of 10 to 30 at a time. These will often come from the side of the map, or at least off the main path directly in front of you. That's designed not only to keep your guard up, but to ensure that you seldom see them coming. The director maintains a budget system in which it observes how many zombies are in the map, and will either add or delete them as necessary. If the number of zombies on screen goes below a particular threshold, and its objective at that time is to increase intensity, it'll add more wanderers, mobs, or special infected. Each type of zombie has some sort of condition that dictates how it can be entered into the game. While we already mentioned the regular zombies, the special infected are equally constrained. The specials, notably the hunter, jockey, spitter, boomer, charger, and smoker, are restricted such that only a handful of them can be on the map at any given point in time. In addition, only one of each type can be on the map at once. This is designed to ensure a sense of balance, that you're not being wiped out, for example, by a herd of hunters. Equally, these restrictions ensure that players have a chance to defend themselves or rescue others. It doesn't mean the players will succeed, but at least they're given a fighting chance. Lastly, the boss zombies. The tank and the witch can only spawn at certain specific locations as determined by the designers. Now, these spawn points are deliberately awkward in that they force you into confrontations. While the witch can still be avoided if you move quietly and refrain from disturbing her, the tank is unavoidable. In fact, this is because the tank will always attack players once any line of sight is established. This is to prevent the player from being able to avoid the tank, which was actually possible in earlier builds of the game. However, one small consolation is that once these events take place, the director will refrain from adding more zombies, otherwise it would prove too chaotic for most players to handle. Nice to see it's considerate that way, isn't it? While the director is largely focused on the zombie spawning, the system does make other changes to the game. Item spawns are placed based upon a collection of preset locations set by the developers, though the system will also swap out certain items based on player performance. In addition, there are also some more subtle changes to levels, as well as the audio that plays in the background. The director communicates with a separate audio manager, and players can begin to predict patterns of behaviour in the game based upon what audio is played. The most obvious cue is that of the tank, given the change of music.
I didn't take a hit there.
Oh, you guys be kidding!
That's a tank.
Oh my god! However, similar cues for other events exist. You just have to listen very carefully. Lastly, the director is not always in charge of the game. Certain points of each level will result in the director being turned off, to allow players to either move through a particular story sequence or prepare them for a major event, such as the episode finale. However, when these events take place, the system can be allowed to go a little nuts, and this can sometimes result in rather sadistic behaviour, with masses of zombies spawning in while one or even two tanks are in the same map. The director system of Left 4 Dead has proven to be an inspiration for a number of similar approaches that have appeared in other AAA games. Notably Far Cry 3 and recently Far Cry 4, and even less violent or aggressive games such as Rocksmith 2014, where an AI director observes the player playing guitar during the session mode and provides a backing band to accompany you. But for now, that's it for this AI in Games video. We've survived the zombie horde. Don't forget to read the written piece, which is linked to in the description, and we'll see you next time.